morning, everybody, and welcome to the Canadian Mixed Championships here in Toronto at the Weston Golf and Country Club. My name is Dolores McCann, and I'm here with Dale Curtis, past president of the OCA. And the games are underway. We have today Nova Scotia and Quebec for you. Quebec won the hammer, so they've gotten through a few rocks here, cleared out the house. Good morning, Dale. Welcome to the Weston Golf and Country Club.
Thank you, Dolores.
How have you been enjoying the games? Have you been here for most of the week?
I was here for two holes on Wednesday.
There have been some really, really great games here. We had Nova Scotia on our televised sheet yesterday as well. They played really well against Northwest Territories. And it looks like they're off to a good start here.
Players certainly are enjoying this ice here at Weston.
They sure are. Lots of swing, nice fast ice.
Certainly means that they can put a lot of rocks in play.
Yeah.
And some finesse shots as far as waiting for that curve. Ça la fin.
Yep.
The jackets are already coming out, so it must be nice and warm out there for the sweepers.
They have been, the teams are using the sweepers, that's for sure. There's been a lot of sweeping in these games. And also with that swingy ice, too, they really need to be able to do that.
Yes!
Opportunity for them to just get settled down and relax. I like to play that way too.
There's a good feel for the ice and even just a good downside or side pass instead of the weight.
Ligne est bonne. Tu dans le rond?
Oui.
Amène-la 12 pieds. OK, wow, laisse que là un peu. OK.
Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to translate.
Well, we do have the player's mic, so it's nice sometimes to listen in on what they're saying for their strategy and for the sweeping.
I like that.
Okay.
And there's been great communication, too. It's one of the things that I always talk to our junior curlers about back in Oakland.
Yep, Berg!
Communication.
Relaying down to the skill. Sweepers are knowledgeable in their weight judging. It makes all the difference in the world.
This looks pretty good. Tiny bit of a roll.
Yes, Quebec will be trying to hit and roll to the wings, and Nova Scotia will be trying to hit and roll to the center. Just the difference in the strategy when you have hammer and don't have hammer.
Well, Jocelyn's throwing a hit here. She was stellar yesterday. She played great.
No. Nope. Yep.
And notice on her resume that she has been to nationals before. But certainly that helps in the long run, the familiarity with the whole procedure and everything. And by this time in the competition, all the teams should be comfortable here with the facility and the ice, that's for sure.
Yeah. And it's a long, hard week for them too. I mean, it's tough. Some of them have jet lag to deal with, and it's just really grueling.
Certainly, well, and we heard the two skips talking just prior to the first rock throwing, and one of them said it sounded, he said it had felt like he'd been here for a month. you get into such a routine, you know, as far as games that you're playing and stuff, that you don't even realize days and such.
That's right.
It becomes routine.
Hard, guys,
a bit more
push.
Than they wanted it to. Great sweeping.
Yeah.
You can really hold that if you throw the nice takeout weight. That sweep, you can really hold
Thanks.
That line.
I sure can.
Whoa. Yep. Yep, 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 yep. Go, Jordan, go, 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 go. Hard.
Plays out, they'll just be hitting, and then on Quebec's last rock, he'll hope that he can hit and roll out carry on into the second with last rock.
I noticed that during last night's draw too. We had a lot of blank ends. Got to get those two points at least.
Yes, there's no point if you have hammer just taking one point, then you lose the advantage.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep. Yes.
Hard.
And the last time he was at a national was back when he played
Very
in juniors.
Nice.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm sure he's loving it here. He's playing really well.
These two teams are now playing in the championship round. They've gone through their pools, where there's a pool A and a pool B, and the top four out of each pool then have now advanced to the championship round, where you play the crossover top four teams out of the other pool.
And then I think the semifinals are tomorrow. Yep. Mm-hmm. Finals, are they on Sunday or Saturday? I'm not sure.
Yep. No, they don't.
Be able to check that.
Same thing. Yep.
Okay. Yep.
I know they have the championship banquet on Saturday night, I believe. So. And in that playoff, 1-4, 2-3, with the winner advancing to the gold medal, and then there is a bronze medal game.
Right, so that's it looks like the semifinals are at 10 o'clock tomorrow, and then 4 p.m. would be the finals.
Well, that's good, because it gives the teams a chance to get home after a long haul.
Whoa! Whoa! Yep! Yes! Yep, right up to it. Good.
And for the viewers that are just joining us, and two, they will see that the players are playing with the electronic handles.
Yes, that's right. Yeah. So they have to watch that hog line. We've seen a few hog line violations earlier on in the week. I haven't seen any in the last few days, but. Earlier on in the week, I think they just were just getting used to it.
Well, those electronic handles certainly take the play out of any officials or anything, because the mechanism is set in the ice.
So there's
the rocks,
no question.
And so they have green lights, and if the green lights turn to red, start flashing, then there has been a hot line violation.
Red.
Oh, there, see, you did have to hit, and his rollout wasn't quite, didn't roll out. So Quebec takes its one. He did try and go for the blank, but his sweepers just couldn't get it out. So we'll see if this end gets developed and that it looks like Quebec's asking for a tight guard rather than in. So we may see this end with a few more rocks in play. Nice smooth delivery. The sweeper's hard at work to bring that to the center line and as tight to the rings as possible.
Skip comes out to give it some fresh arms. Shelly Barker coming down now.
Line's okay. Stay with it. Okay. If you can wait a bit. Wait if you can. Okay. Yeah,
you can
now.
Hear the communication there between the skip and the sweepers. And then the sweepers off the get-go thought it was okay for the wait call.
Good job.
And then the skip is letting the sweepers know that there's lots of room to get by the guard, and if they can wait for the break and then bring it,
right,
if the weight is correct.
Worked out really well.
Top four was totally there. It's not bad.
That's pretty good, I would say. I'd like to be able to throw that anytime I wanted.
Control weight, Shell. Control.
The weight was perfect.
Yeah, weight was great. So now Doug is calling for control rate. Take that one out.
Okay, easy.
He'll be looking here not just for a hit, so to speak, but a hit and a roll.
Yep.
So he doesn't set up.
Okay,
the
well, leave it right there. That play is actually.
And he didn't get it. He got a nose hit, which sets up the play for Quebec for a
good to see you
do.
Good bro. Didn't give you a lot of ice.
Tiny little mistakes can make a big difference.
And these skips aren't just looking at this shot, they're looking down the road of how the whole end is going to develop and play out.
Yeah, yeah.
Because in this one, he's actually asking for a hit and a roll to the center. He's not going to get it. But
tiny little flop outside.
Yep. Control weight, right? Close! Yep! Bird, guys! Let it go! Bird!
Well, too much.
Okay.
But there's that nice separation. If you couldn't get the perfect hit and roll behind that guard, the separation now puts two on the scoreboard in play.
That's right,
for Nova Scotia.
Whoa!
They're just waiting on us.
You can see how sensitive that ice is that that was sort of perfect T-line weight, and yet it didn't get the line.
Control weight, right?
To the sweepers, mm-hmm. wait for it to break on the draw, the yeah. curl, and then bring it.
Yeah, you really do. It's very sensitive. No, they're really waiting on this one. Freeze here.
With that Nova Scotia work there, just almost biting the button, if Quebec can get around there and freeze on top of that yellow, it certainly cuts down the scoring area for Nova Scotia to get the two.
Yes. Skipper comes out with some fresh arms again. That looks like a nice shot.
Just a heavy draw.
Yeah. That's right. I don't skip very often, but when I do, I make sure I wear a couple of extra layers.
Well, the skip doesn't do much, you know.
Close, yep.
Hurt!
Gotta go hurt!
Oh, nice shot. That was a delicate weight shot. He asked for just back 8 weight. And look at the roll right on top of their other stone that they got there. Nice shot from that Jocelyn Nix.
Now, having that rock there, does that make this freeze a little bit tougher now? I guess it's going to curl, isn't it? I mean, there's a lot of space between that guard and the top four.
Right, but it just means now that Nova Scotia's looking at 2 rocks, and certainly if they freeze on top of that yellow rocks, it makes it more difficult with the perfect nose to get rid of the yellow rocks.
Yeah, I think so too.
That was a really nice shot by Roxanne.
So you need quite a bit less. That was back, wasn't it?
That was solid. I remember the rocks back as well.
See how nice and smooth these deliveries are. They get the rock out in front of them before the kick and stuff. That it certainly makes it nicer from a skip's point of view
it to sure
be
does.
Able to see what's coming line-wise with that rock.
Just let it freeze that way.
You're staying right off of that.
And I think that certainly Quebec has its an opportunity here, maybe to get out of the end.
It looks like they're talking about hitting that yellow one right on the nose.
Mm-hmm. And you may be able to dislodge, Jocelyn's just dislodged the 2 yellow shot rocks, and maybe enough room there that if he has good weight that he can dislodge them off that forefoot.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's nice.
Oh yeah,
no excuse for that.
So he's just having that discussion with his sweepers about what the plan is. Things around a little.
Just the line up at the two red and stuff, the two red have a perfect angle to those two yellows.
You're right.
Yeah, I think you're right, Doug. Yeah.
No, he's okay. Not going for that, though. Looks like, is he looking to just tap that one back? I'm not sure.
Yeah, I think he just... It's one of those communication examples. Rock throwing is, it certainly helps her call
line's
the line
good,
much
guys.
Better.
Right to it. Yep, you gotta go. All the way, guys.
Yep.
Yep,
go hard
you gotta
on
go.
This.
Hard. Hard. Right up, guys. Hard.
Oh. That overcurled just a little.
He had about that core weight. I don't know when he would have been able to tap that yellow to the back core enough if he had a hit nose on that. Unfortunately, with that little outside roll, he's given Quebec the opportunity to come down here. And I think the indication on the weight from the skipper here is up weight.
Yeah.
I don't know whether we can sell all three here if he hits that on the right angle or not. We're just not we're not directly behind the sheet, so the angles we can't see the angles as well as.
It's pretty close, actually.
Has good solid weight on it.
Got rid of a couple.
Yes. Yep. But that ran a little straighter than he thought it would run. It was nice solid weight that he threw on that.
God bless, eh? This is God bless. I gave you more. Yeah, but we don't want to.
Lots of line.
This is last drop, and to get his second
still
point,
got room,
he just
guys.
Has to draw to the four.
Yep, all the way, right up. Right up, right to it. Right to it, guys, right to it. Right to it. Great shot.
Good sweeping.
Nice.
Sweepers really controlled that one from beginning to end as far as putting it right there on the forefoot.
They sure did. They were kind of on and off it, made sure it got there. Reading the weight is one of those things that I know sometimes I have a hard time with, but it's so important. Knowing when to sweep and when not to sweep.
I think it's an art.
It is. You're right.
Some people seem to be very good at it. It takes a lot of focus and understanding. And watching how the player delivers the stone, how the rock crosses that hog line.
That's right.
So many factors that come into play.
I heard a sorry. Does that mean it's a bit heavy, maybe? They're staying right off of it.
Coming down.
Nice shot.
They may have been looking for a tight center line guard, and they got a top four. That certainly on the right side to error, I would say, as far as after just taking two.
So it looks like Maxime is looking for a corner guard here.
Setting up corner guards is when you have hammers, certainly a common strategy. Looking to score your two. You want to pull the rock solid to the wings.
Yeah.
Make use of those corner guards. Yeah.
With this swingy ice, there have been a few corner guards that have been real far corner guards, way out near the sidelines.
Right, generally speaking, for corner guards, you sort of
put
them on, say, the 4 foot lines.
Yeah.
Have any probably got to have finished Weston, but generally it's a common thing to put them just sort of outside those 4 foot lines.
Right.
Make it tight, it's hard to freeze it. Make it tight.
That's a really nice guard by Shelley.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
Certainly a nice corner breeze.
Okay, we have two other games going on there. Who do we have on sheet C? Manitoba and BC. Looks like Manitoba is up 2-1. And on sheet D, we have Northwest Territories and Northern Ontario. First end was a blank, and Northern Ontario has 1 point in the second end. So Maxime's looking for a tap here, double tap, backline weight.
Okay.
Oh, I think he's changing that. I think he's looking for control weight now. No, that was pretty close.
One.
They got the roll out to the 8 foot on the side there.
Shot better.
Just going over all the options here. Yeah, it looked
came
like
up
it.
A bit too much.
Yeah.
There may have been a double possibility.
Get up there.
Yeah.
Looking for a draw here, I believe.
Thanks.
Trying to make use of these front guard stones if they can get buried behind.
They really have to be patient. Those rocks, they curl a lot, but it's very late. That looks really nice.
You can bring it a long way if you can sweep it like weight loss sort of thing once it takes that break.
Yeah.
I've seen them come around center guards and then peeked out the other side and they've overgrown.
Close.
This is an example where they're not even going after the shot rock, but they're going after the open rock.
Right.
That it's... still a number of rocks left in the end that the play will have to go, so they don't have to initially go after the shot rock every time.
Okay, so he's opting to take that one out.
I bowled on!
They're staying right off of that. Well, it stayed in.
Stayed in and rolled farther out to the wings, which makes it more difficult for Nova Scotia.
Yep. Yes. Whoa. Sorry, guys. Yes. Whoa, 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 Shell.
Oh, it hung in there. Jocelyn was a little concerned about that rock right out of her hand. Looks like it's on the guard.
Bounce and open that up there.
Yeah,
I like the run. Yeah. I'd like the run.
They'll try and use the ring, Yellowstone. Raise, take out.
So what weight is he going to throw here? Is that normal takeout weight?
Oh, okay, yeah.
Just a little less.
Here.
Not catching what he's saying to the sweepers as far as what weight he's intending on throwing.
He did tighten up the ice a little bit.
in there again, because we are directly behind the sheet, he may have to get the other side.
Yeah.
Close.
That might be the issue, because that certainly looks like normal weight.
Yes!
Hurt!
That's curling up too much.
Oh, too bad.
And he closed the gap with that, too. Though we could use it again to run it.
You're right. We have a couple of options. I guess he's talking about the raise versus the draw. Right.
Si je vais là, il frappe là, c'est sûr. Il mène 2-1, puis... C'est sûr, s'il manque le reste de balle, on fait 3. On va y aller. OK, on va y aller au centre. Ouais, c'est sûr, mais... OK. La ligne est serrée aussi, yep, prends la d'avance. Arm! Arm!
Yeah, they're really working hard on that one.
Y'a de la place!
This one's breaking hard as well.
Just la place.
They got it by.
Nice.
Good sweeping.
Really great sweeping. Look at that, perfectly buried.
Wait. No, no.
Do you want my broom up there?
No, you can hold it up here.
Okay. And he is trying that same shot again, that raise on the yellow.
Now that's a bit of an angle, I think, from here it looks like it is.
He has a little bit more room to play with because he can. He has the two red there that he can angle.
Right.
Right?
There. Yeah.
Raise on that yellow.
Just a touch left.
Forward V Titch on the outside. Come across the top of that rock.
Close.
Nice solid takeout weight.
Whoa. Whoa. Whoa.
Good shot. Good. So we got the one red out and sits just biting the eight foot. So Quebec has to, for their second point, just go to the full eight.
You should get. No, I'm going to have a little bit more. J'ai pris plus de glace, petit bit de plus de white aussi.
Skip always likes to be able to throw the same shot twice. So, Max is certainly.
Et ça vous autres, je pense qu'il est là en masse, c'est fort.
First one, so I expect this one to be very close. Out a little farther though, on this one, line wise.
Yeah, that's always something to consider too.
The sweepers are just keeping it clean. Very nice.
Thank you.
Well, Sonia's being asked to come right into the house.
Blanket, yes, Lily.
Close works. Very nice.
12 feet.
They just finished so nicely.
Yeah, beautiful.
Bien bon. Yep. Yep. Yo, oh, il y a place. Beaucoup de place. On peut attendre encore. Better it. Yep.
This looks pretty good.
Four. Go.
I know. Wow, nice shot.
Both of you have a shot.
Very nice weight. You could see how the sweepers had to wait before they could actually pick up on the sweeping. They had to wait for that to break and get that curl.
And that's knowing the ice, knowing the rocks, and knowing how they're going to react to the weight that's thrown. These are things that you have to watch throughout the game and remember. And different paths can be different, too. It's a lot of information that they have to keep handy in their head.
You gotta wait. Oh, and that's why your front end just has to be just as knowledgeable as your skip.
That's right, yeah.
And their job, they have totally different responsibilities mm-hmm. and jobs as far as being part of the team.
Yes. I always like having those sideline chats in between ends, too, because you can share all of this information and just confirm things.
C'est un huit de pierre, feel away.
Sure, it's like four pairs of eyes.
That's right, yeah.
C'est bon.
See things differently.
Yeah.
It's nice to see what's happening out there. If you've noticed any changes, to pass that along to your teammates.
Change le jeu, yep! Yes!
That's pretty good. One goes. So he's looking for a hit and roll here. Makes a big difference. Making the hit is great, but if you don't get the roll, that can change everything.
Whoa!
Well, especially at this level of curling and stuff.
Yeah.
They're looking at every little opportunity to make the shot the best it can be.
I'd like to guard. Thank you.
excellent to release this as well. As far as inside out movement and delivery. Much longer before you get that break from the curl.
Yeah, I think you're right. He was talking about that yesterday. Nice guard. Well, Maxime is just confirming how much of that rock that Roxanne can see.
Just piqué celle-là.
And you can see the skip making weight signals and stuff. And every team has signals for different weight to be thrown, whether it's peel weight, normal takeout.
Yep.
Even hack weight sort of thing that each team has a code.
Yeah!
Yeah.
Okay, well.
She had a few options on that shot.
She did, yeah.
Nothing wrong with that.
And Doug's going to put a guard right back up where that one was. Now, I notice players, too, when they're communicating the weight of the rock to the skip, they have different ways of doing that. Some of them are very specific. Sometimes they say, it's okay, it looks good. So I guess, again, each team has their own way of communicating and what they're comfortable with.
And that's something that gets developed through practice with the four of them together as far as the weight calls. A lot of women's teams use the watches and go with specific times.
Yes, they do.
Some teams actually use that, term it the Furby zone.
Right, yeah.
A lot of it depends on how much these teams have practiced together.
Yes!
And what they're comfortable with.
Yes!
Where's the call?
Yes! Right. Yes!
Oh. Almost got that. Almost got all of them.
Nice hit.
That was a great shot by Roxanne. So Doug's going to come right in and sit on top of that yellow one.
See the difference here too, that Nova Scotia, they keep drawing and they keep putting up guards.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're good now. We're good now.
The hitting game, trying to reduce the scoring. Nice weight.
And I notice too, even, you know, playing at the club level, the different teams, when I see who I'm playing, I go, you know, we talk about it, and we know that this team likes to play lots of rocks in play, or we know another team might like to hit everything and play in the house. So you get to know what teams' habits are, and it helps you to, I guess, not let them play their game.
Strategize against
them. Yeah, that's right.
Playing the first couple of innings to feel your opposition out, trying to make sure that you score in the even ends. When you only have eight ends, then it becomes very critical towards the end of the game, the sixth end, who does the scoring. And that can all be strategized.
Yes! Yes!
What kind of game you actually
play. That's right. That's a nice peel. He would have probably been happy with the run back or the peel on that shot.
Yeah, that looks good.
But with these these games only bring 8 ends, it certainly makes a difference as far as how hard you want to go after them with the scoring.
Only
8 ends.
They used to be 10 ends, right? Mm-hmm.
They did. Yes.
And when did that change? It wasn't that long ago, I don't think.
No, it wasn't. Well, the whole format of this championship has changed in that
pools,
yeah.
The range, I like that one. Fair enough. I can't be shot.
Now, when they go to, when the winning team goes to the Worlds in Russia, are they going to be playing 8 ends there as well? Do you know?
Yes.
This is only the second year that they have that, I believe, so it's something pretty new.
Cross the line, guys. Cross the hole. Ooh,
that went sideways, didn't it?
Yeah.
It's a bit longer. So it looked like it might have picked, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, and if you think about all the slams and stuff, they're all over 8 ends as well.
That's true.
They would have
gotten
it.
And these games are all timed as well. Makes much more sense, and then you're not penalized for the type of game you're playing.
That's right, yeah. I think it's much better.
Mm-hmm. Much fairer.
Much fairer, yeah.
On a deux catchers, là. Une demi-pierre.
Richard is taking a little bit of extra time cleaning the ice on that side because of that pick. They want to make sure that Doug's rock doesn't pick on anything.
Gives the rock to the sweepers, basically, and as you heard Jocelyn just say, it's all you, meaning that it's all up to the sweepers to bring that rock and make it count.
This looks like a really nice rock.
Right up, guys. Very nice.
Beautiful shot.
I see you guys smiling at each other.
Then they do take a break, and the ice is actually mocked. And they have a 5-minute break. It's actually 3 minutes, but discuss any game change in game strategy.
Yeah,
Shelly,
you're deadly.
Prospective coaches.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Do they usually have a bit of a snack and kind of get their energy back up again? So I guess some of them do. It's a good opportunity to regroup.
Yes, at Nationals it is a 5-minute break that they take. You'll see the odd, especially the front end or something, they may be munching on something. Certainly, hydration-wise, they will be drinking throughout the entire day.
Right. Yeah, the front end works pretty hard with the sweet thing. It's something that I always try to emphasize to curlers back in Oakville is that when you practice, you have to make sure that you practice your sweeping, especially if you're front end, because that's, you know, 2/3 of your game is sweeping.
It's all cardio.
Yeah, yeah, you got to be in good shape.
And they're also in the halfway point there on sheet D. And I think Northern Ontario, I guess Northwest Territories like the fourth end, Northern Ontario to the third end, so they're up 2-0 on Northwest Territories.
And then on sheet C, that looks like that's a tied game there too. They're just not quite finished. They have a couple more rocks to throw in the fourth end. Right now BC is sitting one. Maybe two. I can't tell that. There's one at the back. Is it? Okay, they're sitting two. BC is sitting two in here. They're coming down with their last rock right now.
And certainly at the back right point, the front end will be checking the clock and stuff to make sure that they've allowed a bit of time to finish the game.
Right.
And if they are a bit tight, then it's up to the front end to make up some time throughout the next couple of games as they
right.
towards the
yeah.
end of the game.
And I guess that's a little tougher too when they play a game where they have lots of rocks and in play and a lot that can happen. They need to take a little bit more time to decide on what shot they're going to play.
You always want to give the skipper sort of as much time as possible as far as to think about the actual shot.
Right.
And then too, you don't want the skip rushing in their delivery at any time.
Right.
So there's always ways to make, say, make up time too.
Right. So this is the last rock for Manitoba, and they pretty much need a piece of the button here.
Coming down here, it looks hot, and the sweepers are certainly just walking beside it.
Yeah, that's a little bit heavy, so BC is going to steal two in the fourth end. So that puts them up 4-2. Well, they have just over a minute left in their break for Quebec and Nova Scotia, so they're heading back out onto the ice now to get ready.
It's interesting looking at all the bios that we have on the players and stuff that on our sheet that we are featuring today, that all eight players have been to nationals in their past.
Oh, they have?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that's interesting. Well, they should all be pretty relaxed. This is just another day at the office then.
Have fun.
It's got to be exciting for these teams.
Yeah. Said that. I think Sonia's the only one maybe that has not been to a national before. My mistake.
No, shuttle's down here.
Well, all the players are ready to go. They're just waiting for the skips. Shelly's in the hack, ready to go. And Doug's calling for top four.
Just kind of clean it early.
Okay.
You feed it or no?
This is important when you've taken, you know, your bluff, three have points a look. And you're up two. This is where you want to minimize Quebec's chances for taking two, and this is the ideal way of putting the first one.
Yeah.
Corner guard here.
Quebec will generate the corner guards, hoping to get their deuce that way.
And they're walking beside it as well, so they think it's got a lot of weight. Looks good. Nicely done.
Good job. Two guys like in. Not tight. Got tight. Get tight if it's.
There was a discussion there whether they wanted the second one in or just tight. The conclusion were tight, they have to make sure that it's perfect.
Weight's great.
Well, those sweepers aren't getting much of a workout so far in this end.
No, they're just finishing this one off. They waited till it broke on the curl and just took it over to where they wanted to put it.
Max!
See, looking at that, the way they've got that guarded, I would have liked the guard over half a rock so you're guarding on the side that they have their corner guard so they can't make use of their corner guard.
Yeah, that's a very good point.
That's exactly. I don't think it did get over.
No, not quite.
To make use of that corner guard, but you can see
what turn.
The scenario
oh, turn.
I was talking about.
Exactly.
Flirt.
Their throw was good, that in fact the skip should have given a little bit more ice there. That it always helps from a team if the skip lets the players know, you know,
right,
concerning their throw.
Yeah, I think that's important. Oftentimes, I think the thrower will think maybe they did something wrong or, you know, gave it a little bit of a twist when they released it, something like that. So I think it really is good when the skip says that. That one was a little bit heavy.
That was a missed opportunity there.
It sure was. So Richard is going to be getting rid of this guard, hopefully getting a roll.
One of his own out at the back. Not a big concern, though.
No, I think it's more important that that guard is gone.
Yep.
That can use that center guard though now to come
around. Yep.
No, this looks like a pretty nice throw.
Go, Sonia, go.
Yeah, they're just finishing off on the curl.
Now, would this be one of those either or shots again? Run it back or peel it?
For sure. I mean, they actually are looking for the run back.
Hurt. Whoa!
This is where the skip has to somewhere make the decision. Are we going to get the run back? Yep, we are.
Oh,
or are
nice
we going to get the split to make sure that it is actually split? It doesn't just stay there.
Right.
Sort of thing, but,
yeah, that was a really nice shot that Jocelyn made.
Nice run back. And there wasn't big weight thrown on that either. It doesn't require big weight to do those
run backs
whatsoever. It's all a line call.
Yes, Elling! Yes, Elling! Arr! For sure! Go, 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 go!
And certainly with another curl on this ice, with that rock just being there on the 12 foot, it does give Quebec the opportunity to come well around that guard, be shot, and be totally buried.
Right. This looks good.
Very nice, and it's still above the tee line too, so
that's really important, being above the tee line.
Good judging. Well, yes, it is, because otherwise it would allow Quebec just to come down and do this on them with backing.
Right.
Yes! Okay, well.
Roxanne has an interesting way of holding her broom. It's flat on the ice, but it's way out in front, so it's right in front of the sweeper. I imagine they've been playing together for a while, so they've worked that out, but it just looks a little bit awkward.
He just has to be careful with their sliding or sliding foot going around the broom
right.
To get in position for sweeping.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's great deal. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm going to put it right in line with the back one. Okay, yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Just a touch more. I think we're going to get a little curl.
You hear the discussion there? As to exactly where they are. Very important that the sweepers
line's
know
good.
What the shot call is.
Line's good. Roll if you can. Onto this? Okay, not yet. Not yet. Okay.
Yeah. But through that communication, they certainly changed the actual call on the shot.
Wait,
I'm going
to call this guy. No.
They adjusted from back of the house to
trees
on that top one. Good use of that rock.
Elle a pas bougé, non?
And that's again the really good communication between the sweepers and the person in the house, in this case Jocelyn.
It's all about adjustments.
It is, yeah. Yeah.
So I thought it was going to be a touch dead here.
Constantly, right from release right to when the rock stops.
Non, non, on joue pile, wait, on arrache tout. Peut-être on essaye d'ouvrir ça, là. Yep. Arn! Arn!
Arn! Yeah. That was nice. Not sure if he planned that, but it sure looked good.
Yes.
Yeah, we got it. Good playing with the zoom.
We're trying to replace that guard.
Yeah.
Now, where do you think he'll want that? Will he want that tight or a little bit higher so there's no run back?
Line's good. Line's good.
I mean, if he makes the line good,
line's good. It's coming.
Yeah. To hit it out.
Whoa. Sit down, baby.
Yeah, just a little bit. It looks like they can see probably most of that rock that's in the forefoot.
Cards aren't always easy to put on. The perfect guard.
No, placement is critical. And when the rocks are curling this much, that just makes it that much more difficult. It was really gliding. So they got two there, so that's good.
Oh, yeah.
I know. It certainly was the goal at the end to get two or more when you have a hammer, so the goal accomplished.
That's right. I just do.
Exactly. Yeah.
You shoot a roll a little further, you hit it
to make sure the gallery is on the same page.
Yeah, it's really important.
Sue, flush!
You never want to ask your teammates, what are we doing here?
Sue, flush!
So a tight center guard here would be, well, that looks like it's dying a little.
Yeah.
I think Maxim is actually sweeping more than most skips. He's run out there for quite a few shots.
Yeah, hit it early, yeah. Hurt for line, guys. Gotta go!
I don't know if they're by.
Third!
Just top 12.
Just a little light.
Okay. Well, and certainly the indication there to hit it early that the liner was already
right.
Curl and stuff that sometimes if you can jump those rocks out of the thrower's hand, you'll be able to hold the line before the curl.
Yes, Wash! Yes, Lenny! Yes, Lenny! Push away! Oh. Yes, Lenny! Yes! Yes! Push away, push away, push
away! Oh, nice! That was nice.
Regular head weight, so.
Sonia's got to feel good about that.
Yes, that was good adjustment from her first one.
I like the piece of it, though.
Oh, yeah. Uh-oh.
That's not curling at all. No, she had a really positive handle on that, too. That's going to keep it a bit straighter.
A little bit straighter. I think she had some in out.
Oh, she did. Okay.
Tu restes entre les deux ici, c'est bon.
There seemed to be a very early indication that it needed to come.
Ça a l'air fort! C'est bon! Yep!
So, Doug's trying that same thing to come
back
to
the guard. Yep! Yes!
Oh!
Beautiful.
This one even curled more. Nice finish.
Yeah. You got it right. Like that, I. Whoa! 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 Okay.
Very solid weight on that heel. If you need to do damage, it's nice if you have that solid heel weight.
Yeah, that's a good thing to have in your back pocket. They do, They need to get this guard to come over a bit. That's pretty nice.
Just so much late movement on that.
There is, yeah.
Just stay on it as long as I can. I'll get every inch.
Yep!
So Roxanne's going to be putting up a guard.
Ça, ça sera meilleur ça.
When there's this many rocks that are close to the line that you want, I do sometimes.
Okay.
We call the Christmas tree.
Not a fall.
The cards and stuff.
Yeah.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Yes.
Yes. Bon, accueil en masse.
Right.
Accueil en masse. Oh, non, pas besoin de finir. Ouais, cache-toi en arrière. Okay, bun. Looks like
it's going to be pretty good.
Yeah, you can see that little tuck.
That's great.
Okay, good spot.
So that if they lose that red one, they're not getting
right.
Yeah. In the house.
Double PLE. There's the regular cake. Wait. Whoa.
It was good if they'll dislodge the rocks so that they have some straight run backs if they have to use them.
So Quebec is just going to keep putting rocks out front.
I thought they both go.
Well, and you can see where the actual shot rock is, that it's 4-4, so it does cut down the scoring.
Yeah.
Space for Nova Scotia.
Significantly.
This
looks like another really good guard.
Yep, finish.
Nice. That's a lot of red rocks.
You guys want to try to jiggle leaves? Good. You like the run? Okay. Okay, try
to run.
Yeah.
Right. Well, they're a little bit angled, but they could still get to those rocks that are on the 4 foot and 8 foot.
Nope.
I think.
Oh. Nope. Curl.
It just didn't curl for her.
These three rocks
So now we're down to skip rocks, so Nova Scotia is going to have to come up with something pretty quickly. Sometimes three. Weight looks pretty good. It's got some curling to do, but as we've seen, it does come hard at the end. Nice
finish, eh?
Really.
Let's see if we can get a couple of rocks moving, maybe try to get these off the bus.
Okay.
Yeah, he still seems to be wanting to go with the peel.
Off nose, that's
it. Yeah, it's off nose, take the hair, okay?
They're just figuring out the angles now. Once you figure out the angles, I think you really just need to focus on where you need to hit that front rock.
I always think if you play a lot of field,
yeah,
you know, with the angles that you have to have,
yeah,
there, I think it helps you improve. And the other thing is just to go and place the rocks. As in a game, I just try it.
That's right, yeah.
When it breaks.
Yeah.
I remember I was talking to John Epping one time, and he told me when he was a kid he used to play marbles and figure out the angles with the marbles.
Good throw and everything.
Thanks.
Now it's kind of hard to get to the forefoot. Let's see what he does.
Sometimes hard throwing against one.
Yeah.
He has just an angle raise for a blank.
On peut pas bloquer deux, là.
Might be able to run it back again. So.
Yes, that's right.
To the tee line. If Quebec puts this in the center, does make it to
that was a nice throw.
Grab part of the forefoot.
It does, yeah. Yeah.
Wait. Come on, lady. Accueil en masse. Accueil en masse.
This looks nice. Sorry folks, forgot to change the camera there. I think there is a hole, yeah. Yep, he's going for it.
It's a little higher up than the last one. So he didn't get as much finish on it.
See, he, you know what, I bet he can see almost half a rock. I think so. I find when I'm throwing shots like this through a hole, I have to kind of visually make those guards go away and
yep.
not even see them.
Yep,
exactly.
Yep! Good shot.
That was good.
One red.
Nice job.
Yeah, he was. And he came out of it pretty good.
He did.
Pretty good, because it was looking kind of scary.
Only giving up on it, so that's not bad.
So they're on one. They're going to want us to take here. Yeah. They're going to want to try to force us to one. So do you want one?
Trois!
And Nova Scotia had a last rock in the seventh end. How do you want to come home? Quebec will be trying to force Nova Scotia to take it on its way. If you're Nova Scotia, do you want to try and take two here or a blank band so that you have to get coming home?
Is the rock on the ring?
Oh.
We were having this discussion the other day, whether or not coming into the eighth end, would you rather be up without the hammer or down with the hammer?
Totally a team decision.
Yeah.
Some I'm not sure what the stats say, but it's certainly whatever the team, the four players have discussed it, and whatever they're more comfortable with, I think.
Yeah, I agree. And I think oftentimes, too, it depends what kind of a game you're having. I always like to have the hammer.
Nice shot, Dennis.
Yeah, good one.
Nice shot.
Control your feet, or if you have the hammer,
right?
That's for sure.
Yeah.
Yes, push. Yes, push.
It looks like it's way out there.
Get la place, move good place.
They're watching it. They're keeping close.
Before. I think it's a bun.
No, well, just a little bump, maybe a tiny bit heavy.
Yeah.
So Doug's looking for a draw here, draw freeze.
Ooh, close.
Wait for it.
Back coach, back eight. We can wait.
Now that communication about the weight is a little bit more specific. Oh, there's a little bump, that's a nice shot.
Perfect shot. Well, and he could certainly call the line with that, knowing that the weight was eight, that it makes a difference on how that rock's going to break.
Really important.
You needed to get that little inside roll. That rock's just sitting at the tee line.
That a girl.
So they're just going to try and sit right in the pocket there. That's a pretty good spot with two yellow rocks behind you and a red guard out front, sitting on the button.
Whoa!
A little heavy, maybe?
Yes. Good spot.
Heel at center pin.
Hey, come. No. A timeout.
There's a discussion here with that way to heal that top guard.
Let's have a look. You're
going to heal, and then they're going to get. Are they going to fit? They're trying to force us.
Yeah.
You know.
If you could ever get in there with four. What if you throw like, what if you were to throw like line? Yeah.
Yeah,
that's true.
Nova Scotia has an Ontario resident who was a coach a long time ago, a curler himself, Bruce Darnley.
Alright.
Runner straight back?
Turn around.
Oh, it worked out all right. Nice shot by Richard Barker.
Certainly moved things around.
It did.
We take a look at yellow stones. There's three yellow stones now in play on the rings, right?
And all spread out.
Yeah, I like it. Great shot.
So Maxime's going over all the options. So it looks like he's going to try and get rid of a couple here. For sure. A couple of shots ago, it was a very different looking house. Oh, that one's going to hang around. Nose hit here would be perfect. Sure if that's on or not.
Yes, it is. Yeah, just biting the back there.
Yeah.
Go from possibility of blanking to picking up two.
We just keep going back and forth here.
Stone. so that makes your shots easier to get your two, right?
Right.
You don't want to group them together or anything, so trying to take it as far back and make it almost equal. That would have to be an awful flat roll across.
Right. Nicely done.
That was a great call on that line.
Yeah. Really nice.
Okay. There you go. The ice conditions, the way they are throwing that big like, solid weight. There's so much
bad,
ice
yeah.
movement, too, with mm-hmm. the rocks that does make those shots easier to do, and just they're there, kind of thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Whereas,
yeah.
You know, on other ices, you may not be able to get that
right.
solid
hit and
roll.
Blah, blah. Not too
yeah,
bad.
You wouldn't even call it.
Front under human.
The amount of handle on those rocks too helps.
Yes. Yeah.
You know, the positive of a handle when it gets solid.
Yeah.
You know, the rotation.
There you go.
Yeah. I'd measure that one.
Certainly, if I was in opposition, I'd be measuring to see if I was hit. Never know who painted the rings.
That's right. Well, I don't see Dawn here.
Very back and forth. It's great with curling how your plan keeps changing.
That's the fun part. Always, you always have to be on your toes.
That's right, yeah. Oh, they have. Look at that. Sheet C That's Manitoba and BC, I believe. So it looks like BC is up 7-3.
Right.
Sheet D, Northern Ontario scored a big end, so they're up 6-3. Wow. That's a big change in one that sixth end, eh?
That's right. That's right.
Right. Oh, okay, yeah.
Great shot.
Maxime wants this one to come right in the house.
La ligne est serrée. La ligne est serrée, tu vois là. Quelle chance de jouer. Mais là, là-bas. Proche, par exemple, ça. Yep, 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 yep. Plus proche.
Not quite there, but it's a tight guard.
What do you guys like here?
Very nice tight guard.
Pretty tight. Go around? Or go
I think the two guards that are the hardest are the ones that are right just over the hog line and the ones that are just outside the rings.
Line's good. Little curl. If you can let it finish it to here. Yeah.
Oh, that's going to be nicely buried.
Nice shot.
Nice top four weight.
So Sonia's going to want to freeze on top of that yellow rock. Weight looks really good.
Yeah.
Nice.
I'd say the weight was perfect.
I would say.
Yeah, freeze if you tap it here, it's all right.
I'm getting a little deja vu here.
Back four! Okay, roll for line.
You
gotta roll for line.
Just back four.
Okay.
Back four.
Starting to come now. The weight goes back four, which would be the perfect tap weight that he's looking for. Just got that little tap and roll off of it.
Yeah.
Bijon! No!
Oh, Shelly, you're robbed. Your weight was perfect.
What's wrong?
Why?
You might have to do it, for example. Freeze up, lad! What's up, Johnny?
Prenons un timer.
Viens voir.
Yep. to have the discussion.
It's a matter of knowing when to make your move and stuff.
But already
the rocks are in front of those yellow rocks for the shots to come.
Just like pretty
much chest
that curls a hair more.
So
we smock it. C'est ça qu'on aurait deux. Ouais, c'est ça.
No.
So if he's got to play to freeze, let's say he plays to freeze.
Just let it out?
And he chips the yellow on the left back a little.
Is that low? Ah oui, ben, si on la met là, il faut qu'on soit axé pour la sortir. Ouais, va-t'en là, elle va tout le temps trouver. Ouais.
C'est bon.
On va frapper l'autre. Là. On verra, là. Ouais, c'est ça. Mais il va enlever sur deux jambes.
Yeah, I don't think it will.
Maman!
I'll need a little bit more discussion on this one. They have to figure out what's going to happen. So the teams can talk for that time amongst themselves, and then they have a minute with the coach. Is that right?
Lui, ils vont venir ici. Ils vont venir ici. Mais ça va être parfait. Après, d'autres, on peut venir ici après.
Right.
Si tu restes court, c'est pas mauvais non plus.
Right. And we've got quite a crowd here too, so they have to get through the crowd.
Je pense pas qu'il va ouvrir, lui. Il va mettre du gamble pour faire son deux. Il a déjà deux points.
Si tu penses que si on met ça là, il va faire.
Moi, ce que j'aime pas, c'est que si on met ça là, on se bloque les raises. Faut se garder les raises pour frapper. Moi, je pense qu'il y a de bonheur. Je pense que ça, c'est un problème, ça. Si on fixe le haut, attends, première, c'est pas ça. Ouais, et les autres on frappe. Il n'y aura pas de deux, ça va en blague. J'adore, ok.
Usually bring an alternate with them?
Where's the weight?
No, there is that. Players pool.
Oh, there is, okay. If somebody gets the flu or something like that. No, nice shot. Right, yeah. So do they get a chance to have a look at the spare, or the alternate?
Spare pool, yes.
Yeah, so yes. They can spend a little bit of time with them.
Yes, there will be bios on the spares.
Oh, okay.
Yes. And sometimes at some events you even get to see the spares throw.
Ouais, on va se donner de langue après pour le double. Biter vite! Cours, c'est bon!
Sweep
oh,
you.
Yes, away. Oh, yes, away. Yeah.
They're really sweeping this one hard. I got a little wick off of that one, but it's not bad.
You guys see Anna?
Sorry.
Not bad. Yeah.
Yeah, I like that.
This one's good. This is closer to you. What turn do you want to come with? Yeah. Yeah. Here's this one here. Oh, trip. Yeah.
Well, with this shot, won't his shooter stay out front there?
Depends on how it comes off. Got a bit of a spin.
Right, yeah. So it still leaves the other rocks open.
Yeah, now we're going to get much more of a spin than that.
Just a little bit to bouger les angles. Après ça, elle double. Guard?
That's where sometimes if you're a slide sweeper, it's hard to stop and go the other direction as far
guard,
as
fun.
Yeah.
What?
I started doing that this year for the first time. I was playing in a doubles league in the summer. And I had never... I always used two groupers, so it was a bit of a challenge. But it was fun. I don't think I was very effective, but... Yeah.
It takes a lot of core strength to be a good, effective.
Yeah, it really does. And it's a big commitment, too. Our club recently got a smart broom, and it really does it measures your force, push and pull force, and frequency, and it's really, really great. It doesn't lie, that's for sure.
What do you guys like here? Oh, tap up. You like that? Yeah. Just throw back
can't
four.
Hold a smart broom.
No, you can't. You can't.
And if you're a good sweeper, it'll tell you whether you really are or not.
Well, so many times there are debates on teams about who's the best sweeper and who should be closer to the rock. So now I can tell our members, well, the broom doesn't lie. So if you really want to know, we can find out.
I think it's an excellent tool for teams.
It's a great tool for teams.
Clean, yeah. Clean. Yep. Here we go. So
they open the
bed right here in the
garden. Hands!
Like you
guys.
Hands! A little bump there, it didn't really dislodge anything.
No, just tapped it a tiny bit. The other thing that's a really great tool to use is video analysis. And I usually will pair that with the smart broom so that you can relate the numbers to your body position and technique. So it's really, really helpful and very eye-opening too.
It is, because you as a thrower don't always know what you're actually doing.
Exactly, yeah.
You know, and someone to tell you where you're doing this.
The feel is a lot different. Yes, yeah.
Oh, there it is.
Well, I think it's easier for people to see what they're doing rather than having somebody describe it to them.
Okay. Change de jeu. Yes, la ligne, pas jouer. Yes.
It's all about that visual.
It is. It really is. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes, sit down.
Doug's going, what are we going to do here?
out there just to separate them.
He wants to create a little bit of space between those rocks. They're pretty tightly together there.
Yeah. Pretty much all I see is...
But yeah, then he might double and stay right there. What if we just rip the front right?
Hey guys.
Yeah, what kind of weight do you think about the plane?
Just tell it to throw by your board.
Okay. Yeah, or just hack. Yeah, hack on this one.
Okay.
Yeah, that...
Hack weight.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a bit of a cushion.
Right,
so
yeah. Yeah, it's nice to have a little bit of time in the bank.
Looking good. Yep. Yep, go then. Hurt.
Hurt, got it.
Hurt. Whoa.
Hurt. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Whoa, whoa.
Whoa. Okay. Yep, yep, yep. Hurt. Good.
So they changed the angles a little bit.
See it?
Well, there is a path to the button there.
Right. Second shot. They're almost to the floor.
Now, is he going to want to come right behind everything here?
Sure.
I guess the worry would be if it ticks and rolls out open.
The other thing is if he comes behind the tee line, then it allows Nova Scotia.
Yeah, he really needs to throw this well.
Further too.
Yeah. That's right.
Go. It's sweet.
Right there?
Yeah. That's kind of the danger of that shot is to act exactly where it would end up, what that would give that Nova Scotia.
Like in that? Right on top?
So Doug is just going to throw the exact same shot here and sit right in front of that one.
What? Yeah.
He can make the perfect freeze, and even if he can almost titch on the inside of that red rock, because I know Quebec is looking at the other side.
Mm-hmm.
So that if he was a titch on the inside of that red rock, then the yellow's not going to double out there.
Right.
Line's good. Lots of room, coming now. Whoa. Whoa.
It's got a curl.
Looks a bit hot.
It does. No, it's not going to come over. The weight actually looked pretty good. Not sure what happened there.
Quebec's called a timeout just to give themselves some breathing room before throwing. Okay. There's a nice little pocket created in there now.
Should I make it?
If Quebec sits in
there,
I think it will.
You see, Johnny? I would stay caché. Il va, sauf que lui, il va avoir le in-off, là. Si jamais freeze, il n'y a pas le in-off, par exemple.
I think he was looking at that slash on the yellow guard that's over on the corner. He doesn't want to leave that. I think so, yeah. Yeah, there's some high fives over there, so I think they must have had a good end. I didn't see what happened. The game over on sheet D is finished, and it looks like Northern Ontario came out on the winning side of that game. So here comes Maxime's rock. Sweepers are staying close, but it's got a curl.
Yes!
She's called their time out too. It's nice that you
get in there, right?
At least yeah. One time out at the end of the game if you are tight.
Right, yeah.
Liking that?
Yeah.
Did I think I was here before?
You were there, yeah.
Right there in the right way, I think that was it.
Okay.
You think?
Yeah, I do. Maybe just a little more. Just there, right there.
Was they on the
no.
Broom?
No.
You were on the broom,
okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. It's just that
sensitivity.
If it's
sweet. It is. Well, BC and Manitoba have left the ice, and it looks like BC came out on the winning end of that game. Manitoba needed to score three in the eighth end. They scored one, so BC won that game 7-6.
The shot basically is all up to the sweepers as far as judging the weight, relaying the weight call down to the vice in order for her to call the line. He has to get on the inside of that red block.
Line's good.
He certainly had lots of time on his clock. Minute 13 left.
Yep. Okay, bro. Roll if you can. Roll if you can. Whoa!
We need to go hard on this.
Okay, yeah. Oh,
so close.
Half a rock short.
That's got to be frustrating.
So, Nova Scotia gets their 1 point to tie.
Well, this has been a good game.
Half a rock difference.
Yeah.
Half a rock more.
You'll be having nightmares about that shot.
That's why I was worried a little bit, but you guys had to go.
Yeah. They had it.
Good game.
She's great.
And three cracks in the tap.
Are they going to have a little meeting with their coach?
Yes, this is where they get the 3 minute break between the end of the game.
Like the mid game break, right? Is the same?
Yeah, for the extra.
Yeah, good.
It's just like the mid game break. 4 minutes.
Right. 3 minutes? Did you say 3 minutes?
Try for two and then, yeah. You try for two.
Your streaming went okay this time? I heard there was a really nasty glitch last time. Something wasn't working.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah. Because I had somebody here try to last night, I wasn't. I heard from them that the live stream video was...
Well, I know there's... The home end is kind of choppy.
Sorry?
The home end, the camera's a little choppy.
But you're using a really low bandwidth USB camera, so I'm not surprised. That's that one there, right? The one on the box?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. Because that one's not designed to run
full
bandwidth all the time.
Yeah. So I'm just not using it too much. I'm trying to having the camera at the opposite of the wall.
Well, see, there's a huge difference because when I chart a game, the way we chart it, with just all the rocks and all the rock motion graphically, the whole game probably fits in less than 2 frames of your video. Seriously. So I used maybe 15th of a second of your data, and I've got the whole 2 hour game.
Oh, wow.
No problems. Because all I'm charting is rock positions and rock motion.
Right, yeah.
So most rocks, it's... When you throw the lead stone, it's the rock color, which is a number, like 0, 1, you know. The rock number, which is another number, 1 to 16. And a coordinate. How far it is from the pin. That's it. That's all I see.
Wait, there, Joe.
Oh, I better get
four numbers. So it's incredibly dense.
Okay, it looks like everybody's ready to go.
How are you?
Not bad.
Good. Nice to see you.
Yeah, you can go, Joe. You don't have to wait.
How did London go for you? You were in London last weekend, weren't you? Were you? I thought you said you were down in London last weekend.
So our extra end is started now, with Shelley Barker throwing her first rock.
This one probably, what, the high one?
Yep.
Yeah.
It's going to be super high. Okay.
Yep. Nice show.
Good job.
That's the tick shot tried here.
Ah, it's our first tick shot. Mm. So, what weight would this be then? For is that like board weight? Is that what you use for a tick shot?
Most teams will use the board or hack weight.
Ooh, almost.
Because the other goal on here, if you don't happen to do a tick, is to make sure that it's thrown rock goes through the house.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Trying to get one out of play.
Yeah, it looks like the other
turn.
That's
right.
So,
okay.
I think most teams go with the packed board. And that could actually, the weight could be a difference in whether you're trying to keep the delivered stone in play as another corner.
Oh, I see, yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Two or three, you've got to pick up points. Then you can do this.
For two corner guards, right. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, you gotta go to finish it. Yeah.
You're in the ring.
No, I don't think you are.
The other thing that comes into play in this extra end is the fact that now that the ice has been cleared, and the fact that there's no other.
Oh, you're right, yeah.
Sometimes changing ice conditions come into play.
That's right. They're going to have to keep an eye on that. So here's Sonia's second attempt at the tick, not quite. So Doug's looking for a center guard here.
He'll be trying to jump this up as much as possible.
He sure will.
Keep it clean.
Doug's coming out to help them. Great sweeping.
Good encouragement there,
yeah.
Too.
I think the yelling really does make you sweep harder.
Yeah,
I know.
Need to wait on this.
Maxime's looking at the angles again.
See what he needs to get the double. This is where you want to get rid of the two yellows, but make sure your shooter goes as well.
Whoa, 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 whoa!
Very nice.
Really good shot. Doug puts the broom down right away, no question about what he wants.
Mine's gonna be good in the end.
You can hear those sweepers grunting and moaning as far as.
Yeah, they're working hard.
Well, they're putting 100% of the record into that sweeping and stuff.
They sure are. Looking for a peel here.
Whoa! Whoa, 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 whoa.
Oh! Oh, almost got two. Yeah, that was close.
Have been reset for this extra in for 4 minutes too. Like the, you don't get to bank any of your time from the game to add it on into your extra end or anything.
Right. Too bad. Doug's gone out to help with Jocelyn's rock here. Looks like a nice guard. Big difference.
Then you should not be penalized for the type of game that you have to play in order to, you know, win.
Right.
Whoa.
Oh, nice shot.
And there's your double peel. Sells a shooter. Wonderful shot.
Well, Nova Scotia is really trying.
Good brush, you guys. Look to center. Very nice. Good. Very nice.
Yes, with only three rocks left to come, and there's nothing else in the house with that high.
No, I think they're hoping for a mistake.
Yeah, they'll be looking for a nose hit on this. That would be his only saving grace.
Yeah. I think he got a little worried on that one. It was curling a bit. It's really important.
Nice,
yeah.
To know that your teammates support you.
The positive frame of mind is really important. I mean, when they get to this level, everybody can make the shots. It really often comes down to what's going on in between your ears. That's a smart decision.
Whoa.
Yep.
Whoa!
Yes! Yes!
Whoa.
Clean.
Yes.
That was pretty good.
You always like to hear that. Just clean.
Yeah. Good game. Quebec gets their 1 point. For the win. It was a good game. Well, that's it for us. Thank you so much for joining me, Dale. I know I kind of roped you in unexpectedly, and I really appreciate you coming over and spending the last couple of hours with me here behind the camera.
Well, you're welcome. It was very nice. Nice to pay attention to a whole game, that's for sure.
Yeah. So I believe the next draw is at 2:30, and Janet Murphy will be here with you for that. So signing off from Weston, I'm Dolores McCallum with Dale Curtis, and hope you stick around for the next game. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi.
Jerry is going to come in and he sets it all up.
Right.
So that all you have to do is go. So that's.
Okay.
These are my little key cards. Yeah, I'm going to leave them because I'm not coming back.
Oh, so. Are you done?
Yeah. But I just, you know, whichever two teams are playing, I just have them out and then that way I can save the names. But the names are going to show up on here anyway.
Right. So in this seat, you actually can't see what's going on.
Not on sheet one, no, so you might want to move over
here.
Okay. And then just take the microphone with you.
Right.
So it's a good idea to have these on because then you can hear what the volume and everything is, and if somebody's screaming really loud, you can turn them down.
Well, then I've been listening to you guys, and a couple times I've texted you, and I'm like, the players' mics are way too loud.
Yeah.
You know, like
James has been doing that. Yeah. So it's good.
Yeah.
But with that, you'll know. You'll be able to hear everything.
And how close do you have to be to this?
Like it depends on how much you've got your volume up.
So you can
so
be
if
like...
if you don't want to sit too close to it, just crank the volume up over there.
But then that also, I think, picks up a lot of the background noise too, right?
So
you kind of... I'm sure a few people will text me along the way.
Probably. but you know what? That's good. Yeah. I like to have that feedback. So when you're... Just kind of play with these buttons and you'll get used to them pretty quickly after a couple of events.
Right. So
and just go back and forth. For the first end, I kept forgetting to change the player. See where it says next player? The game is over, so it's not highlighted. But so every time somebody throws a rock, just change player, change player, change player. Or next player.
Next player.
It'll show up here.
Oh.
And that's why it was kind of good to have these, because then I could look down and go... Don is supposed to be, but that's Max's picture, so I didn't change it. So every time somebody throws a rock, you click next player, and all of their information will come up here. When you want to put the score in, you just put the cursor in the box, type the number, however many points they got, and then update scoreboard.
Okay. And then if you want to be like, okay, we're in between ends, you can... You do the all scores and that'll pop up.
I didn't even do that.
Okay.
I can only handle one thing at a time.
Yeah.
So if you want to play with that, you can. I didn't even bother. We verbally updated the scores on the other sheets, but I didn't update them in there.
Okay. Well, and they must just be getting updated from maybe from the those things.
Yeah, the
streaming.
Yeah. So
there is no overhead home. Oh, no. There is. What's the overhead home?
No, he did have yesterday, like on other days, he did have split screen pictures, but I don't know how he did that.
Okay.
And I didn't want to start clicking buttons.
Right.
So I was just going back and forth, like I said.
Get ready for live stream curling, only at curl.
I was just using away and home.
Away and home,
I just
away
went
and home,
between the two.
And we'll just have to get him to tell us what to do. Like, that's not...
That would be just if you want to take the delivery from the far end.
Yeah, but
terrible.
It's saying home and overhead home must be the good one. Yeah.
I
so it's
overhead
home and away end are the best.
The way this one is set up. It's not right because it's very blurry there. I'm just going to... And I know that's not the way it's set up. Can you find this one again?
Sure. No, that's not away delivery.
Hi, Janet.
Hey, Don.
How are you?
Good. Are you going to come commentate with me? Okay, there we go.
What?
Maybe. I am...
tough questions like Mr. Murphy does.
Oh, please. The toughest question I'm going to have is, how do you know how to work these cameras?
Kind of evaded his questions a little bit.
Do you know how to set these cameras up?
I haven't got a clue.
No,
I don't. That's kind of my standard answer this week.
Yeah.
When anybody asks me anything... I say, I'm sorry.
I thought your question and answer with Hugh, with respect to the rocks at Weston, was a really good informative segment. I was like, there you go. Let's...
Okay. I need to busy.
You're going to go do ice?
Yeah.
Home delivery. That's better than it was, Dolores. Except it's just a little bit cockeyed. It's like not flat. They're better. Okay.
It's,
full.
How thick do you think? Not too thick. Just kind of
better.
It's so
Oh, there.
So that home delivery, yeah, that's good. You can see them coming out.
And you can use the overhead one for that too.
Yeah. Home tight.
But yeah, that'll be a good one. That will be one that you'll use a lot. Mm-hmm. And then.
So at like 2:20 or something, Jerry just starts moving it around and getting it set up.
Do you have his cell phone number?
Probably.
I should give it to you.
Probably not. Sure. So just try texting him now and just tell him that you're getting ready to do the next draw and ask him if he'll set it up for you. He'll keep in touch with you and make sure that you're okay before he, you know, signs off. The other thing you're going to have to do is watch.